Hello everyone, welcome to this video on how to configure the relative date filter in dashboard widgets in Bold BI. Let's see the overview of the relative date filter. Using relative date filtering, you can apply time-based filters to any date column. It enables you to select a subset range of dates anchored to a particular date. The relative date filters make the dashboards flexible and more user-friendly. Relative date filters can be configured in date pickers, list boxes, combo boxes, and date time columns. First, I'll show you how to configure a relative date filter in a date picker. In this HR training dashboard example, a date picker has been configured. I'll edit this date picker to show you how to configure a relative date filter in it. Under the Assign Data tab, click the Settings icon in the Configured Date value and select Relative Dates in the drop-down menu. If the Relative Dates option is hidden, switch to the Properties tab and set the selection type as Range. Now, you can see the Relative Dates option in the drop-down menu. Configure the relative date and click Add. Repeat this until the required set of relative dates is added. I have added last 15 days, last 30 days, and the required relative dates to filter the dashboard. You can see the added relative dates in the date picker, and I can filter the dashboard based on the selection. Next, to filter the dashboard widgets based on this configured date picker, we have to enable the Act as Master Widget option, which controls the interdependency of widgets in a dashboard with respect to dynamic user interactions. Here, we can select or deselect listener widgets that would respond to user interaction in the master widget. Let's preview the dashboard to see the changes. Here, I have selected the last 30 days relative date filter, and the dashboard is filtered based on this selection. You can create as many relative dates as needed. Let's see some relative dates configured in real-time examples of the date picker widget. Here, the tickets by source and tickets by priority are the listener widgets of the Select Date Master widget. So, when I select a relative date, the tickets by source and tickets by priority were filtered. In this next real-time example, I select a relative date from the Select Date Master filter. The top 5 won opportunities and sales progress by country listener widgets are filtered to showcase data from the selected date range. You can configure relative dates in list box and combo box widgets by following the same procedures as for the date picker. Let me show you a real-time example for the list box widget. For this date's list box widget, in the relative date options dialog, I have added the required relative date filters. So, when selecting a relative date filter from the date's master widget, the listener widgets are filtered to showcase the number of products sold and the completed activities for the selected date range. Next, let me show you a real-time example for the combo box widget. For this date combo box widget, in the relative date options dialog, I have added the required relative date filters. So, when selecting a relative date filter from the date master widget, the listener widgets are filtered to showcase the participants by training mode and their feedback satisfaction levels. Next, let's look at configuring relative date filters on date time columns of widgets. You can apply a relative date filter to any widget configured with a date time column. In this healthcare executive dashboard example, for this operating revenues and expenses by month widget, I wanted to show only 6 months of data. For that, under the Assign Data tab, I click the Settings icon in the Configure Date Time column and select the Relative Date Filter in the drop-down menu. Here in the Relative Date Filter dialog, I select the month range type and then the last 6 months as the period of time. Now the Relative Date Filter is applied within this specific widget to showcase variation in operating revenue and expenses for the last 6 months. You can configure range types and period types in the Relative Filter dialog this way. You can also create a relative date filter up to a specific date. Next, I'll show you a couple of other widgets from example dashboards. In this real-time example with this plan versus completed tasks by date widget, I have configured a relative date filter to showcase the last 3 days of planned versus completed tasks data. In this one, in the revenue trend widget, I have configured a relative date filter to showcase the last 6 months of revenue. Likewise, you can utilize the relative date filter to apply time-based filters to any date column in your dashboard. Please leave a comment with any questions you may have or any additional features you would like to see in Bold BI. Thanks for watching.